Give me a high five if you believe aloe vera gel is a vibe. Isn't it one of the most beautiful ingredients? I'm going to be talking about aloe vera gel for your face, acne, and your hair. The reason why aloe vera gel can be used for all three is because it's anti-inflammatory, it's soothing, it's healing. You know what? I'm going to break down each of these qualities as we discuss face, acne, and hair. For acne, it is exceptionally great because it reduces inflammation and redness. And it has zinc and copper, which directly affect the healing of acne. You can use it as a post cleanse. You can even use it as a part of your spot treatment because aloe has BHA. So you can apply it on open pimples. You can apply it on pimples which are drying up. It's a great spot treatment. You can make a spray of aloe and use it on your skin. We're going to be discussing how to make a spray a little later on in the video. It's extremely hydrating spray. And that's not all. You can actually use it for fading your PIH and PIE without drying up your skin. My favorite aloe is from HerbSense. This is not a sponsored video. It's just a brand that I discovered recently. And I've been in love with their aloe vera gel. It is just so beautifully done. It doesn't have anything added to it. It's 99% pure aloe vera gel. It has no fragrance, no additional slip product added, nothing. Absorbs beautifully like a dream. I've just been in love with this ingredient. Since I have dry, dehydrated skin, I often use it before my moisturizer. And as you can see here, it gets absorbed almost immediately. And the best part is that it has absolutely no pilling, so goes in beautifully with your actives as well as your other skincare products. It is great as an anti-aging gradient in your skincare because it's packed with 18 amino acids. Because it is an antioxidant, it actually protects you from the free radical because of sun's radiation and environmental pollution. It even helps if your skin is very dry, especially when you're an oily, dry kind of skin type and you require just a hydrating ingredient. This is brilliant for you. It is absolutely beautiful for anti-aging benefits because it works in controlling the wrinkles, it improves skin tone, it improves sagging, and it improves scars. The reason it's able to help scars is because it has an ingredient called aloin, which works on the scars. And that's why it's also able to help you with PIH and PIE. It does a brilliant job of preventing water evaporation from your skin. So if you're somebody who has a very dehydrated skin, you want this in your skincare, apply it before your moisturizer and you're good. Aloe vera gel is a brilliant healer. In fact, you can use it very easily with the retinoids, especially when you're going through the retinization process, when your skin is very dry or flaky or is very sensitive. And because it's a natural BHA, it really helps in deep pore cleansing. You could add it with your cleanser. You could add it with tea tree oil. I love tea tree oil and a great ingredient for as an antibacterial for your skincare. So it's brilliant. Just use very little, just a drop in about a tablespoon of aloe and you're good. It also enhances the penetration of the other ingredients, which means that you could actually use it post your cleanser and before your actives. Your actives might just show you much better results because the aloe is going to help them enter and do their work much better and smoother. Did you ever believe aloe is great for hair? I'm here to tell you that it is brilliant. It is great because it has 75 active ingredients, and most importantly, apart from the fact that it's healing and moisturizing and hydrating, it also has proteolytic enzyme. You're going to be talking about it. If you have dry hair, you can spray it onto your hair and your dry hair will be gone. Aloe vera gel is brilliant for hair health. How do you ask? Well, it actually helps improve the health of your follicle. It's packed with vitamin B12 and folic acid, which actually make your follicle healthier. Remember, you're given folic acid when you are just expecting a child? That actually is great for your body. It improves the iron levels. It's really good. And whenever you have high iron levels, it's a good condition for your hair follicle. It also helps reduce hair fall because it's packed with proteolytic enzyme. This particular enzyme actually prevents hair fall. Didn't I say it's brilliant for your hair care? This enzyme goes in and activates the dormant follicles of your hair and makes your hair denser and thicker. Woo! It's a natural cleanser, so you can use it in your last rinse. You can mix it with your favorite oil in 1:1 proportion. It'll help you get rid of an itchy scalp and also might help in preventing dandruff. Applied regularly, aloe vera also helps in stopping hair fall. Let's make the spray now. Take about 3/4 of water and mix in about a tablespoon and a half of aloe gel. And shake it up nicely. You'll see the aloe is on top of the water. We need it well mixed. And your spray is ready. I in fact use aloe vera gel to get my hair straighter, especially when there's a lot of humidity in the air. I just take it directly on my hands and walk it through my hair. It's good to use a claw method so that you get it nicely along your hair. I do such funny things at times. So yeah, it works brilliantly for hair. I work it all along my hair. And as you can see here, my hair is already looking so much more tamer and nicer and sweeter, definitely straighter. I comb it through so you can see there is no residue, which is one of the best things that aloe vera gel has. The ingredient completely dissolves or disappears into whatever use you're putting it to. And as you can see here, my hair is straighter and much more tamer. Here's the before and after. And that's my hair after 4 hours of using it. It's still looking fairly good and straighter. The beauty of aloe that is worth celebrating is that how beautifully it kind of converges into every formulation, into every use that you give it without leaving any residue, without leaving a mark completely, right? And so that's possibly one of the reasons why aloe vera gel is never celebrated as this brilliant ingredient. It is healing, it is soothing, it's packed with nutrients, it's packed with vitamins, it's great that even as a drink, and it's so good for face acne and hair as we saw over here. Which brings me to a very poignant thought. What's it or who is it that we want to be? Do we want to be an aloe vera gel in our lives? You know, and I'm laughing at the connection because it just struck me that it is so easy for us women to become a great wife, to become a great daughter, to become a great employee, to become a great mom. Because women traditionally, and I think also the way we are, we're just very comfortable playing the second fiddle in a lot of relationships. We don't want halla. We want to be the peacemaker, you know. We appoint ourselves the custodian of every relationship that we come in connection with, you know. We want to be the great wife, the great girlfriend, the great daughter, the great mother. But I think it's important for us to take a step back and say, who is it that we want to be? And to spend our life trying to nurture who is it that we want to be. Because at some point, we have to come to a realization that just because we celebrate ourselves and put ourselves in front of other people's needs or ahead of other people doesn't mean that we are bad people. Doesn't mean that we are being selfish. That is what the whole narrative tells us, that, you know, women should always be more sacrificing, more loving, more adjusting, for God's sake, you know. Sure, be all of that, but not at the cost of who you are. And who you are is going to evolve. Let it evolve wherever it takes you. Go with the flow, but don't leave it hidden. Don't let it be. Don't suppress it. Because in the later years, and I can tell you from my own life, it is so important to be your person so that, you know, when the kids have gone, the parents have settled down to their retirement, when your husband has his own life in a career or a job, or if you have your own career, you want to be at a point in time and say, you know what, I did this for myself. I stood up for myself. I was able to justify the reason I was born. And the reason you were born was to celebrate yourself and your birth and you as a human being. The fact that you're here is enough for everybody around you, right? And they need to celebrate you. You don't need to become their perfect person to be celebrated. They should celebrate you irrespective. And people who love you and respect you and recognize you for who you really are worth and who you really are, always do. And I say this from my own deep experience. I've been in a shitty hell marriage, and today I am with the love of my life. I am the same person. Yes, I've changed a little bit along the way. I definitely have. I changed a lot of things about myself when I walked out of my first marriage, because for me, the journey was inward. I was like, you know what? Yes, all those things were wrong with the marriage. Yes, all those things were wrong with that person, that setup, that scenario. But what is it that I can do with myself? What can I change within me so that I live the life that I want to live, so that I become the person that I want to be? It's a journey. It's a journey, my friend. Like I always say, the journey is inward to the outside. Spend your time with yourself. Learn who you are, the good with the bad and the ugly. Embrace it and be proud of it. And set your own goals. Who is it that you want to be in the next 6 months, the next 1 year, and work towards your goals? Don't worry about the audience. Don't worry about the people around you. If they really love you, they'll be there for you at the end of the journey as well. I'm so happy that we make this connection. And I wish you all the best in the most important journey of life, the journey of becoming you. I'm going to meet you in the comment section.